How about now? You guys got sound now? Oh my
Kathy, gosh. Lori, what do you got? You got it?
All right. Sorry about that, you guys.
No
oh my
sound.
Gosh, we're
Something
sitting here
wrong.
Talking. No, it's back. You
it
guys
back?
Should have
you got it.
Now. You guys should have it.
Mary?
Now. I think I saw the problem a little bit too late. Right. So thank you guys for bearing with us for that little lip
yes,
sync.
Yes, Kathy just wrote yes.
Thank
okay.
you guys for being
yes,
able to
Lori's
read lips.
Yes, okay.
So
okay. Sorry.
What I was just showing you.
So again, so welcome, and it's our 29th episode. And we're going to show you some of the giveaways you're going to get
something.
For putting up with us.
There's always something. Thank you for bearing with us. So we are giving away, if you leave a comment...
Oh, by the way, we like the word succulent. Sorry.
Yes. Oh, yeah. You know
it's succulent, succulent, succulent.
I like the word succulent. It's fun to say.
I can't lip read either.
To say.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Right? So we are going to be doing the succulent garden today, and wait till you see what Linda has done.
Yeah. I became
a
fan last night. I wasn't always a fan.
It's amazing. It is absolutely amazing. You guys are just going to love this. And so I was just showing you, if you couldn't...
Now we're catch up on the voice.
Ripley.
Ripley's, believe it or not.
Right? Oh my gosh, it's going to be one of those days. It's going
to
be one of those episodes, you guys. You know all those episodes where...
like, subtitles.
Right, where it's 100% blooper. It's
going
to be one of those days. Be ready to laugh. Wendy's already laughing.
Where's the margaritas
okay, so
at? Ooh, Germany. Hi, Germany.
We are giving away the, these are the white treat boxes. They've got the little clear lids on them, and they are right next to the succulent garden in
Over
the
page.
Catalog. We have an avant-garden stamp set. This is a celebration stamp set, and this is here because somebody didn't claim it.
Yes, so you
need... make sure you claim your prizes.
Fill out the form,
go,
or we're giving it away.
Right, there's a link above. Now, it doesn't matter if you leave a comment. Actually, if you leave a comment or mine and Linda's lives right now, you'll be entered into these drawings. And we are giving away... this is the vertical garden project kit.
You're going to see this in a minute.
You're going to see this in a minute. Okay, that's it. There we go. This
and
is
I give
a little
you tips
better.
On how to make
oh,
it
my gosh,
faster
wait,
and easier.
You guys are going to die. Look, if you have overlooked this in the catalog, going to freak out today. Because I did, and now I'm like, oh my gosh, I need 100 of these. So anyways, we're giving one away live, and we're giving another one away for after lives for you guys
next
that can't.
Episode.
So even if you don't win something now, we'll be drawing one of these again in the, episode 30, which is on February 28th. So... we're going to start with just a little recap of what's happening in case you guys missed this. And welcome aboard, everybody. Oh, my gosh, I see you guys. So some of you are
Hi.
Just popping on now and you missed all the entertainment.
Not my computer sound
problems. When we were like, you know, just talking and there was no sound.
Yes.
So
yes, thank you for sticking with us. Now I guess everyone's coming on late and seeing
and
sound
so
problems. Sorry.
And the after live...
the rebroadcast.
You know what I'm trying to spit out there? Thank you.
Recap.
That prize
the
for the succulent garden, the vertical garden kit. You can leave a comment on Linda's channel, on my channel,
Facebook
both on
channel.
Facebook or on YouTube.
Yes.
Everything is included in this drawing.
Yes.
So we're going to show you the last episodes in just a minute because we're going to draw the winner for that. But Linda also has a bonus prize. If you leave comments on her channel,
so,
she's got a bonus here.
Yeah, so if you leave a comment on my blog post for the recaps for this week and last week.
And that's craftystampin.com.
Yep. And also the Facebook and the YouTubes. I'm putting you in for, see if I can get it so you can see it, the All Things Thanks. Win me! So I'm giving this away. So leave comments on my blog.
So you can win
please.
A whole, you got chances to win a whole lot of stuff here.
Yep.
A whole lot of stuff we're giving away, which is really exciting. So for,
here. While you're at my blog, so I'm going to throw in another thing. Okay, so this went up on my blog yesterday. This is my card. This is my submission to Kylie Bertucci's
Absolutely
international
beautiful.
Blog highlight is what she's calling it.
Yep.
And you get
we
to
love
vote.
You, Kylie.
Yes.
Kylie's in Australia.
So everyone
awesome.
Gets to vote on who gets to be in a blog hop at a later date. So but go to my blog post, go to craftystampin.com. This went up on February 14th. Go to my blog. It has a button. You can go over to Kylie's. You can pick four cards, four that you like. I think I'm number 10, but you can see it. So I just, please, but go check out Kylie's blog.
It's even more beautiful now when you guys can see it.
Yeah. So go to my blog. It looks prettier over there.
So we'll start with what's happening now in Stamping World.
Yes.
So Celebration is still in effect. That is the special that happens every time this year where you get
free stuff.
Free stuff with every $50 order. And there are special limited edition sets. And it was just announced.
More free stuff
is coming on Tuesday. There's going to be 3 new Celebration products added to the lineup. Nothing's being taken out, but these are being added.
And that's glimmer paper.
Yeah, it is.
Glimmer.
It is.
Sparkles.
It's awesome. I did a little live on it last week, and it's just amazing.
Yummy.
So we have the Make Medallion stamp set, and we have the Reverse Word stamp set. So these are all brand new coming next Tuesday that you can also get with a $50 order, as well as all of the other Celebration products. And so that's what's happening in Stamping World. We also have an Easter card swap that was just announced yesterday. The Stampin' Demonstrator group is doing it, but if you are a demonstrator, you are also welcome. All demonstrators are welcome to participate. There is an event on my Facebook page, right here on my Facebook page. They're due March 10th, and all of the details are on it. So if you're interested in joining, and you don't have to be a demonstrator, but because it's a demonstrator swap, it's all Stampin' Up stuff. So
you
can read the guidelines, and if you want to participate, even if you're not a demonstrator, you are welcome to, as long as you follow the guidelines. And we're very excited about it. We love all the Easter ideas and sets.
It's fun,
With a big holiday coming up, it's fun to have new, fresh ideas to share.
Yeah.
So, we're going to start by drawing a winner from the last episode.
Ooh.
It is the January Paper Pumpkin Kit, which was
this
the Adoring Arrows. I know.
Adorable. Make good love, wedding, other options.
So, give me one second. Ooh. I got to pop on over here to the right place. Ooh. And we are over on random.org. I have entered in, and I'll do a quick scan through here. If you look real fast, you might see your name. There was over 300.
Wow.
And these are just unique. So I entered you all one time. Everybody got entered once. But, I mean, there was over 1,000 between all of the channels, which was really,
wowzy,
really freaking exciting.
Wow.
Thank you, guys. I mean, we're just so, so excited. Oh, somebody got a duplicate entry there.
Uh-oh.
Carol, uh-oh. She's got a
bonus. Cecilia and Celia right there.
All right. So well, hopefully some of you might have gotten lucky that I missed
name
you.
One way.
That if I missed you the second time, you might have got a little extra chance, and hopefully we'll see what happens.
Love free stuff.
We do love free stuff. So here it goes. When I click randomize, whoever's on top is the winner.
Da-da-da.
And
go.
Winner is Valeria Rose. So congratulations,
awesome.
Valeria. You can claim your prize by clicking on the link at the top of my of this video. I have the winner's circle link there, and you can claim your prize there, and I'll get it right out to you.
Uh-huh.
So congratulations. That was exciting. And don't forget, if you comment now, all of your comments are entered into the live drawings for all the stuff I showed you a little while ago, plus you'll be entered into the after live.
Yes.
For those of you who have to watch it after because you have to work or, these things happen.
I know.
Okay, so you guys ready to start stamping?
Ooh.
I am. I cannot wait for Linda to show you these things. We're going to start by showing you the Succulent Garden, the suite, which is in the Occasions catalog.
Yep.
And we'll show you the products there so you know what we're working with. Here's the catalog here. This one goes through May 31st. These products are limited edition.
Yep.
And so they'll be available until the 31st.
Yep.
It is found on page 20 and 21 of the Occasions catalog.
It is super pretty. Like the colors, especially with the DSP.
So Linda, Laura Peck Grillmeyer, I don't know if I'm saying that right, asked if we make an album for the Paper Pumpkin stamps. Yes, and I have a link to that if you click on my Paper Pumpkin page on my stampwithtami.com blog, and I show you what I did there to store mine.
I'm like, what?
For the Paper Pumpkin stamps, because they have exclusive stamp sets that come with those kits. The Succulent Garden here is it's a whole suite of products that were all made together. I'm going to show you them up close, but the stamp sets were made to go with the paper, the framelits, and you actually get a discount when you get the stamp set and the framelits together. And then
we love a discount
on page 22.
Birdie Moore.
This is what you're going to see today, and you are just going to die when we show you this. So we'll start with
things are falling down.
Avalanche of equipment.
Hold on. don't mind here. We'll do like, you know, birds while she's coming by. All right, here we go.
So here is the you know what I didn't grab is what? The frame.
I got them right here.
You got them? Oh, thank you. Gosh, just when you think you got everything. Oh, she's so good, and she's even got hers on a magnet.
There we go.
Oh, you are so good.
There we go.
So these are made to go together, so the framelits actually fit. Some of the framelits fit right
yes.
here. Fit the flowers to cut them out. It's a two-step stamper, which means two or more of the pieces fit together.
Color's number 12.
Color's number 12.
Thank you. I meant to look before I ran out of the house, but I forgot. So I'm 12 on Kylie's blog.
Yay!
Thank you.
Maybe after this episode, we can get you up a couple of numbers.
I know. Come on.
So here is the designer paper that's made to go with it. Again, these images match the stamp set. So they all are really made to go together, and the colors are fantastic. Mm. The paper is all double-sided. And I'll go through it kind of quick because we did show it off on a previous episode, but it's still beautiful. And I love the gingham.
I love the gingham. I've used that the most. I'm going to have to order another pack just to get more gingham.
And a great background. So here's the gingham and the crumb cake.
Yeah.
Just so pretty. And then stripes. And these are just great, great backgrounds here.
So Lori's saying no sound again. So can somebody just
that you can hear sound? Let's move this down a little bit. Yep. This might help. This might help, actually.
I just want to make sure that we are actually having sound.
Bumped a light into the...
Oh, okay.
Hopefully, guys.
Yeah, we're in a very small spot. You may not... You can't see the whole thing.
Time, so hopefully you guys can hear us a little better now.
Okay. Yeah. I can hear. Okay, so awesome. I just want to make sure.
Awesome.
Lori, I hope you can hear.
So, next up... In the suite is the matching ribbon. So in the colors here, these are, it's a combo pack, so it's two. And this is the sweet, oh my gosh, I'm drawing a blank.
Sugar sweet plum. Sugar sweet plum.
Sugar plum, yeah. Sweet sugar plum.
Sweet
help
sugar
plum. Help us out! Help us out!
Oh my goodness.
We need a lot of help today.
Sweet sugar plum.
And it's, this is,
it's on the back of the paper.
Oh my gosh. It's all escaping me today.
Sweet sugar plum.
Thank you. And the ribbon, I don't know if I can get it up close enough so you guys can see the texture of it. It's super soft. This might help a little bit. Can you see that there? It is so soft.
Go back a little so that it's kind of out of the light. There you go.
Oh, just, it's, I mean, you just want to like pet it.
It is very soft. It is. As an interior designer might say, it has a good hand.
Oh, okay. There you go.
I took interior design for a while. Talk about the hand of the fabric.
So I'm going to show you just a couple of cards made with those supplies, and then we're going to show you the vertical garden kit. So I'm going to do that one last because that one's my favorite. So we're going to start with...
Lori,
and I'm not starting in any particular order.
Slow down. Someone did ask us to slow down. I know it all is so pretty.
Well, we have a lot to show.
I was
going
to say, it can't be a four-hour show.
We have a lot to show. So you can always go back and pause it later if you need to.
Yeah.
And we'll have some of these on our you know,
blog.
Like, we'll have these samples on the
tons
blog
of
later,
info.
Too. So this is one. That was actually Linda's.
That was mine.
Linda's card right here, this first one.
Yeah, I did for a swap.
Some of the designer paper. It's got the pretty petals on the background. Very, very pretty there. And here's another one. This one, Mother's Day card here.
That's
it's got
isn't that
the
pretty?
Stamp set and the designer paper in the background here, and then the framelits cut out this little piece
that's
here.
That's really pretty.
So that is very pretty. And then this is the ruched ribbon here, so this is a little different ribbon, but you could use that the ribbon from the suite there. And this is a Veronica Zales.
I love that one.
Veronica, you know, her work to die for.
Yeah.
But here she did the two-step stamping with the flower and then cut it out with the framelits.
Yep.
Layered it over the designer paper. Two little pieces here of the designer paper. And then one of the new lace doilies on the background there.
That is pretty. I like that one.
Very, very pretty.
Someone else's mind is going beside. Yeah, we're all going.
We're all going there, Sandy.
2 steps forward, 20 steps back.
Oh, my goodness, yes. I told you, it's going to be a blooper kind of day today. We started out with no sound. It is what it is. But it's all fun, right? That's the fun of going live. You just never know what's going to happen.
Very true. Very true.
So here is another one with the gingham and the banner dies here.
Yeah,
and then this is the dies with the flowers on them. The stitched shapes in the background of that one.
Yeah.
And the last one here. Oh, just love it. This was a Veronica Zales. She stamped the white on the tips.
Yep. And that's on the stamp set.
It's in the catalog. It shows you how to do that. And then she's got the little stitch shapes where she punched out. Hold that up so you can see it.
Yep.
Where she punched out half of this oval here.
That's a cool idea.
And the gingham.
To only use half of it.
Yeah. Yeah, just love it layered over some of the banners' dies. Vicky's on overload, I totally. And we're just getting started, Vicky. Oh, shit. Yeah. Linda has not even started with the vertical garden kit. Wait till that comes up.
I love to hear all the different ways you pronounce things. Like, uh-oh.
Yeah, especially when I can't remember the names. Yeah, then it really gets fun. True. I start making them up.
Yeah.
One more stamp set that's in the kit that comes with the vertical garden. A piece of this vertical garden, so I'm going to pull it from something else. It's this vertical garden stamp set comes with a vertical garden kit. Here's the kit. Yeah, thank you.
I'm coming. Hold on.
Linda to the rescue again.
It's multiple pieces.
Okay, so Denise is asking where the tip of that stamp set was.
Well,
it's right on the very first page of this suite.
Is this what you were looking for?
Uh-huh. It's this, but the catalog.
Oh, catalog.
The occasions catalog. I don't know where I put it. Where? It's this. This is the stamp right here, and I'll bring the card back.
I got it.
Oh, thank you.
Hold on.
I'll bring that card back just to show you. And if I can. Where did I put the card?
Coming in. Okay. I don't know if I mentioned. So right along here at the bottom of the catalog on page 20 is the instructions on how to do the stamping on the bottom.
This is the stamp right here. She stamped it in white.
Yep.
And this is the outcome.
Yes.
See the little tips there were stamped in white. Okay, so here's the vertical garden kit. This is the stamp set that comes with the kit. We are giving this kit away.
Yes,
we are. I don't even know where to start.
So many. You know what? I smelled that when I opened it.
Did you really?
I'm like, wonder how this one smells.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't want to rip the Ziploc because I like being able to.
Yeah, it's a nice, heavy duty.
So
you can
nice
reuse
to be
it.
Able to put stuff in.
Yeah.
So here's how the kit comes, and it has these instructions in it. And they are not in English on this page.
No, but you get four languages.
Rest assured, it is on the other pages.
Yep. English is right here, the first one.
There's English and better yet,
pictures.
The universal language
the pictures.
Of photos.
Yep. Yep. IKEA mastered it. We're doing the same thing.
Right. Most excellent. So this is, and this is the kit made, but we're going to show you it made in just a second, because Linda has one.
I do.
So here is the ribbon that comes in it.
Okay, so help me all. Email Stampin' Up. You want this ribbon by the yard.
Oh, my
this
gosh,
is
look at this.
Stunning.
Oh, my gosh,
so,
I did not know.
Oh, and so it's like the seam binding we used to have, but twice as thick.
Look
it's like an inch and a quarter.
This is fabulous. Oh,
love
my gosh.
Love this ribbon.
Love it.
Your teacher gift from a perfect Mother's Day gift.
Yeah,
or a teacher gift. So, yes. All right. So, also, here's a tip. So, I'm going to do tips while Tammy's out.
Go ahead. Linda.
When you start doing this, there is a hole here. This is your tray that the succulents are going to go in. And I don't know if you can see, there's a hole up here that the this ribbon is going to go through. Put this in immediately, because if you don't, you're going to forget, and you're going to hot glue in all your succulents, and you'll never be able to get it in. So do that as soon as you get it. As soon as you open it, there you go. You can tuck it behind so it's out of the way. But so when you were doing your project, you already have it in there, and you don't have to worry about it again. Don't ask me how I know.
Linda has gone through the hard part for you, so you can just enjoy. So here are the pieces some of the pieces. So these are the spiral flowers.
Now on this, you get, I don't even know, you kind of like 10 of them. You have to pop these out. Here's the thing. They come all nice and neat, and I'm trying for the camera. Neat and stacked out. Pop them all out at once. All of them together. Save yourself a little bit of time. So
excellent.
It's just easy.
Excellent.
Easy to do that.
Great,
all at once.
Great tip.
I'm going to save you a little time while you're sitting in front of the television doing this.
So, and then these are some of the banners in this box.
Yep. Now the banners are, there are vanilla on one side and they are whisper white on the other. And you're going to be stamping on the vanilla side.
I didn't realize they were two different colors.
Yeah. And from what Stampin' Up! Has said, is it's a little different material than our standard vanilla cardstock. So when you do stamp on it, you're to hold the stamp down a little bit longer. My advice also to you when doing this is to practice when you are stamping. because it did take me like 5 times before I got the perfect lineup of the double stamp, which we will show you. So just practice on a couple extra pieces. As you can see, like here is our vanilla. Here is the, you can see it's a slightly different color because I ended up having to cut my own because I didn't practice first. So practice first.
Let me see how to tell you what not to do from her experience. So here's the die cuts that come in the kit. These are the different colored, which you're going to get to see these up close in just a minute.
Now there are 2 sheets for each color. You need both sheets to make so you're going to make 3 of each color. There's a big, medium, and small. And you need both sheets to make all of those.
So Linda's going to show you that in just a second.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Holly says she totally overlooked this kit. You know what, Holly? I think we all did.
We all did, yeah.
I think we all did, but wait till you see this.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I'm so, so happy we decided to do this week because... We had overlooked it.
We
opened it up and Linda started playing with it.
I'm like, this is pretty.
You know what? I don't even need to say anymore. I'm going to let her show you.
So let me show you the finished one and then I'm going to show you how to put one, a couple of the flowers together. So let me, I got my ribbon off of it. So see if I can. So here is the finished, I don't know if you can see it all in there. So I'll go from top to bottom. So here's the ruched ribbon, and I got it in a nice bow. Sorry, it's a seam binding. In a nice bow. And then as it comes along, all uber pretty, and they're all kind of stuck in there. They are hot glued in there. So you got to make sure you have your hot glue gun, and you're going to have a few less fingertips when you're done. But it does work.
Oh yeah, you know what? This is upside down. You can actually show them this way.
Sorry.
We have the camera flipped for you.
Sorry if you can see it there. So there it is with the ribbon at the top.
Yeah, sorry guys, we're not.
I'm looking in the wrong spot. Okay, so because I'm over here. So let me show you how to put together one of these. So here we go. I'm gonna pull out the 2 mint macaroon. Ones. Did a light just go out? Light just went out.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Hold on. Technical difficulties.
Let me see if I can figure that out.
The light. All right. So I'm going to keep chatting for a minute while she's doing. So here's a few things. I bought these. These are little flower pots. And I use them to hold some of my utensils while I am working.
I got it.
Got it.
I'm on
it. Hold on. She's on
it.
Oh, there we go.
Did I do it?
There we go. So... to put the succulents together, it's best to use the Tombow glue. And what I like to do is I leave it open and I stick it in my little flower pot. So it stays
Denise says it looks even better right side up.
Yeah. So it stays up and the glue is always pointing down so I don't have to always keep trying to get the glue down to the point. So it's always at the point. And you're going to need a bone folder because you need to curl these. And then any tweezers you have, old tweezers you bought that don't actually tweeze anything.
Right. Have 100 pairs of those.
Yeah, so grab those. Those are all helpful. So
Cynthia says she wished she had ordered this. There's still time.
There's still, you can
get
them.
It's available until May 31st.
So the instructions tell you that, so you're going to make 3, and you're making a small, medium, and large. And it tells you that, it kind of gives you this code of the die cut. So this matches up with the die cut on here. And 1, 2, and 3 is the large. 4, 5, and 6 is the small. And 7, 8, and 9 are the medium, I think. But I took a pen and drew this around so I could just sit it in front of me and visually know which ones I was popping out at a time. So put the 2 together. And I just put my hand behind and kind of push. And out they pop. Done.
Nice. That's a great tip.
Yeah. So it makes it a little faster.
Angel Nielsen, thank you so much for sharing. Thank you all for sharing.
Oh,
you guys are the bomb. The bomb. We love that.
All right. So I'm only going to actually put together 1 flower, but they all go together the same way. So let me put that over the side. So what you want to do... let's see. So I got my sizes together. I'm hoping you guys can see this and move stuff out of the way. So I'm going to take my bone folder, and I started putting them together and kind of curling them as one unit. Just, again,
make it go a little faster. And you just want to curl up the sides of the petals.
Thank you for sharing, Cynthia. And yay, Linda, we're glad you found us too.
Oh, thank you. All right, I'm trying to, do I move closer to myself or further away?
So you're good. You're perfect. You're right on. Okay. You're right on.
And I also found, because it is possible when you're doing this that one petal may rip off, I found that if I'm doing two layers at once, it's less likely to happen. Kind of like rope, you know, it's made up of a lot of little strings, and together they don't break as much.
Thank you, Sandy and Cindy. You guys are the bomb.
Oh, awesome. All right, so we do this.
I wish we could give you guys hearts back.
I know.
You know, it's cool that, when the hearts start flowing, but I want to be able to return them.
Yeah.
Maybe we should write Facebook and ask them if there's a way to do that. Can we heart back?
So now that after I've curled them, so also one of my best friends is the silicone.
Oh, that pad. I have just started using that. That is fantastic.
If you're using glue, this is what you want. So put that down. Okay, I got my ink. And what you just want to do is add a little back in my thing. And you're just going to offset.
Oh, you got so many hearts going right now. Oh, that's so beautiful. Thank you, guys. Thanks for the love.
What you can do is do each of the sides separately. Together. Oops. And you do get a little wiggle room if it moves. The Tombow glue does not dry instantly, hold on.
Thanks to this new table that has little cups on the side, it caught everything. Linda just dropped. It didn't go flying on the floor.
Move my hands around lights so that you can see me, but okay. And then we're just going to assemble these three different sizes now together. And then one more.
I had never used that silicone mat until recently. My mom was using it for adhesive.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my gosh, I never thought to
do that. And you know what it's good for? If you have ribbon and you are putting snail or fast fuse on the back of the ribbon and you always get some on your
And that's what I was doing when I was putting adhesive and it overlaps and gets on your underneath and wrecks your...
Yeah. So
I use the grid paper, but now the silicone mat, you don't have to throw your paper out.
Great.
It's fantastic.
So here is one, and I've left it very open. And as you can see here, they're very curled. What I did was I made mine all open because I wasn't sure. Some are a little more open than others. And I went back when I was finally putting together, and you can kind of squeeze them more together. And I just sort of curled them.
That's so cool.
To try to make them each their own, you know.
The mat is in our online store. It's in the Stampin' Up! Big catalog, the annual catalog.
Yep. So that is how. So you just repeat with all of the different colors and all the different sizes. Plan like an afternoon, a snowy afternoon, to sit down and get this done.
Greta says every time she watches the wish list supply grows. I know the feeling.
So, of course, I didn't bring a... I'll find something. Oh, we got a pen. Okay. So these are roses. And so, like I said, you pull them all off together. I'm not going to do that to Tammy on her one. I'll just pull one.
You can take them all out.
Take them all out. They come out a lot easier as one.
I think that's a fantastic tip. That's excellent.
Yeah. It just, after you do a bunch, you're like, okay, how can I make this go faster?
Oh, love you, Anita. She's like, let's blow it up with smiles. She's sending all kinds of happy faces. We love you.
There we go. Okay.
Oh, you know what? Lori has an excellent suggestion here. Yes. She says that silicone mat is also good when you're inking ribbon. If you use a sponge to color your ribbon, or a marker to color your ribbon, having that underneath, that is a fantastic idea, Lori. Thank you.
Okay. And you can do this. I'll do this again. So I did this, instead of just doing one, I took like half. So I do a whole bunch at once, because you kind of want to curl this up. You want to kind of break in the paper fibers a little bit. So you just take a pen. Let's see if I can line them all up again. I just undid them. Do-do-do.
And Wendy has an awesome suggestion here too. She said you can stamp the tips of these flowers just like the card that we had showed, and that would be absolutely beautiful.
I have
and Linda has a little.
Wait, you see? Wait,
I know.
I went a little sucky.
And you know what? This is phenomenal over the top, but Linda has more to share.
So I'm just gonna wrap this around a pen. A pencil would be better. This I'm using a Sharpie that just happened to be here. But you want to kind of break in the fibers of these, I guess, roses. so that they kind of become.
I love those nice little roses round. Too. They're so yep. pretty.
So I do a whole bunch just to get them where I want them. Pull them out. Pull out my pen.
I especially like your sound effects.
Okay. And then let's PSO now. And pull out one. All right. So I'm going to put the rest of them back. So what I would do, so this last piece here is going to be the base. So I like to just fold that. And then...
Stay tuned, Denise. Denise says a little sponging on the edges would be pretty, yes, too, and it absolutely would. Yes. Hold that thought.
Hold that thought. All right, so I'm... Now you're going to round these up.
Oh, thank you, Lori. Lori says the silicone craft mat is on page 182 of the big catalog.
This is where I end up using my tweezers, is I kind of spin them and I try to get... You then would take, and I'm not turning it on today, I've already lost enough... fingerprints. But you would put some little hot glue right there, and you would set this down, and then you would kind of adjust with your hand if you haven't lost it.
Move
with
it up
hot glue.
There. There you go.
There we go. Or your tweezers to adjust the flower.
They're on the edge. They're on the edge of their seat, Linda. Yep, they're dying.
To the size that you want, and then let them sit, and then they'll all dry. To get them all in here again, you're going to want to use your hot glue gun. So you put a little hot glue on the back. I stuck them all in there, trying to figure out where I wanted them first. Some of them were popping out, but got an idea, and then glued them in. Squished some a little more, opened others up. So that is, I think those are all my tips on how to do this kit. Again, with the stamping, it's a double stamping. Practice. Practice a couple times. But it's photopolymer, you can see right through it. It just took a couple tries. So, you guys...
Wait, you see this? Oh my gosh, you guys. I'm dying.
So, grab the dies again. Okay. Let me show what I cut out. If you saw Tami in my Instagram or our Facebook, I put a picture up.
Linda sent a teaser yesterday.
Yep, of all these lined up. So, here are the dies that come in, and this is called Succulent Framelits, so it's just simple. I used for these... That's one, two, okay. These three, which are the same shapes that are in the kit. They're just a little smaller. So I cut two of each of these to make these. So, all right, I'm making you wait longer. I am.
By the way, your little water app popped up and said you need to drink more water.
I need a drink of water. Yes. I ignore that app. See how effective it is?
It's so funny that Linda has an app that actually tells her she needs to drink more water.
Yep. All right, so we're just going to go in order that these came up. So what I did was I inked these. I didn't use the little stamp that comes in the... stamp set. I just used my sponges and sponge daubers and added ink. So
I'm so excited about these. They're so pretty.
Yep. So this is using Pool Party, and this will all be on both blogs. I took pictures of all this morning. So we're using Pool Party cardstock and the inks, and the inks go from like inside to tip. So this is Sweet Sugar Plum, and then Rich Razzleberry on the edges and on the tips. And you would normally, because you would want to do both sides, but I was trying to do more.
Hearts are coming.
More than
hearts are coming.
For you. So you would do both sides. And these would be cute. I've seen if they had a like a little flower pot. You know, you can see a little flower pot.
I saw them on a photo frame, too. Yeah. A photo frame would look really nice, like a white antique-y photo frame. Yeah.
So there's
that. Chevy chic.
There's that sample. And here's what I did. I just cut a piece of... cardstock when I was cutting these, and I just did a bunch of samples. So these are what I came up with. So here's this one. So let's see.
Molly says she's sold. She's got to have the kit now.
Right. Here is...
For the babe cave. I love it. Oh, my gosh.
Cave.
That is awesome. We love you, Holly.
Love it.
Oh, my gosh. That is so funny.
Okay. So this one is Rich Razzleberry cardstock.
I'm putting that sign up down here. The babe cave.
I then put Whisper White. I let that dry really well. And then I covered that on the edges with Always Artichoke. And if you Google succulent colors, you would not believe the number of options
gosh.
That are out there. So
here
is raspberry.
That is...
Isn't that pretty?
Striking.
Yeah. Now, I didn't
so
do the middle. I really
beautiful.
Wanted you to see the
right,
difference.
Right,
but I would... If I was... If
Amy says she loves it. Yeah, awesome.
Here,
hearts are going crazy.
I would do something in the middle. but I purposely left those open so you could see.
Did you here show that little hold show this?
Oh, my little card. So my little sample card. Yeah, all right, okay, so I'll tell you. So here I did with just the raspberry with just the white, and then I did the artichoke on the bottom and the white on top, and I didn't like that. So then I went with the white on the bottom, and then artichoke.
Yeah,
so
that's striking.
So absolutely, if you want to play with different colors, this is my suggestion. It's just because I didn't want to ruin the after I took me so much smaller. Add all these up with the big shot. All right, so our next one.
So here you go, Donna says, the flowers in the kit needed more, and here are some suggestions. And as some of the gals had suggested, Wink of Stella would be great. Yes. Stamping the tips with white would be great. Even sponging them tone on tone with the same color would be great. But here are some even stepped up ideas for them. And Linda has a whole collection of colors here. Patty says, freaking amazing.
So this uses soft suede first, and then just delightful Dijon on the tips. Now, I really don't know if this is coming over on
I think you can see it. Okay, hold that one down on the light just a little bit.
The gold that the Dijon adds on the tips, it really just makes it pop. So it's
beautiful.
Really, really pretty.
And I never in a million years would have put those two colors.
Now, I will tell you.
Never would have put Dijon on purple. Ever.
So here we go. Back to color theory. They're across from the color wheel from each other. So golds and purples are quite popular.
Well, I love the gold and the purple. I love together, but I never would have put Dijon on plum. Never. Yep.
Here's my sample. Of course, I don't even know what some of these are. I think I started with a green. I made it put artichoke and didn't show up, and that's when I went.
Cindy Hope says amazing video. Thank you.
Oh,
we love
welcome.
You.
Thank you. Alrighty, next. All right. I don't know if I want to show these off.
Oh, Wendy, that's a fantastic idea. Okay. She says you could change this up and make a succulent wreath to hang on the door.
Oh, absolutely.
That would be awesome.
Absolutely. Oh, I don't know now I'm losing my sample code. There it is. All right. So this is mint macaron and whisper white and cherry cobbler. So the white is in the middle. And then so that it kind of goes white, mint, and then the cherry. So this is one I Googled. When I Googled the succulents colors, there was this one that was just minty with bright red tips.
Oh, so pretty.
And I just thought, oh, I got to do that.
Kathy's asking, are we stamping on the kit or can you do this with the dye bundle? Both.
Both.
Both. You could do it with either. Yes. The kit and with the dyes.
I did the kit exactly as directed in the instruction. So you can then take it.
And then you can step it up with these ideas.
Go to town.
But you could also, the dyes match the kit. So you can do both.
By this point, by the time I got to this one, I kind of had a feeling I knew what I was doing. So I just did the white and the red and went, that works. That one works. All right. Are we getting the greens are my favorite. I'm trying to save those for last. All righty. All right, we'll start with this one. Okay.
Lori says she can't wait to play after this.
Okay. Oh. What are you... They're all sticking to each other. Go away. All right. So, here we go. This is Pear Pizzazz.
I love this one. I love it.
And the ink is... So, you can see there's pear on the petal itself, and then just rich razzleberry on the top. These are mouth drop.
Yeah.
You know,
that's
stunning.
Amazing. Amazing.
How pretty they are. So, so pretty. And so, here's... Again... Same color combo there on the edge. And I don't think I ever would have put so much rich razzleberry on green.
I love it, though. I love the color combination.
Okay. This one is always artichoke. And then...
And cherry.
There's always more always artichoke in the middle. And then cherry.
Yes, Kathy's asking if these will be posted on the website. Yes. Absolutely. Yes, they will be.
I took pictures of all that just look just
takes
like
us about an hour to get this to get the replay video up with the on the blogs.
Yeah. But so come back a little later this afternoon.
We'll have them up there.
Yep. So here
Linda has really she's done an awesome job putting them together too so you'll be able to get
you can tell exactly what these are.
You'll be able to see them all.
All right. So here I was trying indigo, maybe suede. I wasn't taking notes. I was just if I didn't like it, I just moved on. So artichoke, and cobbler.
I'm hoping that Stampin' Up! Has enough kits that they don't sell out after this episode.
All right. This is one of my favorites.
I love it.
Garden green, and then there's always artichoke on the petal that comes further down on the petal, then whisper white, and then rich razzleberry. It's just yummy. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Make sure I get the light. Super duper pretty. So And then last but not least, I think this one's my favorite, but it rivals that one. Is Wild Wasabi.
Deborah says, I'm watching live, but not sure you're seeing any of my comments. We see your comment.
Oh,
I see this
comment. There you go.
We see you now, Deborah. We see you now.
Wild Wasabi Ink, Whisper White, and then Rich Razzleberry.
I'm just loving that razzleberry with the greens. Pretty.
So now, let's see if I can bring them all in for a grand finale.
Oh, yeah. And the way you see them even all together.
Yeah, hold on. Let's see. Before I lose, I want to lose them all. Boop-a-doo.
We'll help while Linda has sound effects.
Yeah, there's lots. I was trying to, you know, I wanted to, didn't want to attach them to these papers so that I could kind of show them all together.
Oh, so pretty.
Yeah. So.
Perfect.
Can you see all those?
Perfect. Yeah.
So those are our succulents. Dun-da-da.
Oh, they're beautiful. Yay. Where's my applause button? Yay. Woo! Oh, that is awesome. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Linda. Those were amazing.
They're,
absolutely
they're fun.
Amazing.
They're fun.
So, just awesome job.
Thank you.
Awesome job. Seriously, was that over the top?
Yeah. So now you need to make succulents.
Right? Right? Yeah. Who knew? Who knew?
And they're not, it's not
that
hard.
They were just hidden in that little catalog. Like, you never would have noticed. And now I'm like, oh my gosh, I have to, like, make these for everything. Yeah. I want to play.
Yeah. And you don't have to water them.
So, right? You know. Right? Actually, somebody made that comment. I'm never buying live succulents again.
Nope. Because that's funny. Yeah. My house, if you're not a kid or a dog, you don't really live. Because the kid and the dog, at least, are like, hey, feed me. So
good times. So we are ready to pick a winner. We have come to the end. We're going to draw actually more than one winner. We have a few prizes here.
Right.
So we are going to pop on over to the prize drawings.
Here we go.
And the first one we're going to give away here
is
the
boxes.
The little boxes. So let's
white gift boxes.
Yeah, we're gonna pick a winner by your comments. You have a couple of seconds left.
Get in there.
To leave another comment and. The winner of the white gift boxes is
dum-dum-dum-dum. And oops.
Wait for it. Come back to me. There it is. Veronica Cordry. Veronica Cordry is very lucky.
I go, did she not win last time?
Yes, I think she did. Very lucky. Okay, so we have more. So if you guys win, be sure to fill out the prize claim form.
Yep.
On the let's see. Now that we've got I think we've got all of our issues fixed, we can actually switch back. We can actually switch back and forth again.
I'm thinking, I'm like ready to stick my nose in to write the name down.
It's been so long since we've been able to do that.
Yes.
So this is the Avant Garden stamp set. This is a celebration set. This is one of the ones that you can get free with a $50 order.
Yep.
And the winner of that one is... Wait for it. Oh, well, it would be nice if I actually checked off what they need to do to win. Okay, so... The winner of that one is Jesse Rose Schmidt. Congratulations, Jesse. Oh, yes. And let's see, what else do we have down here to give away?
Okay, so we were giving away one of these kits, right?
Okay, so I think the last one. All right, you guys all want this one. I know you do. All right. This one is for the kit that Linda just showed all of our...
Yes.
So this is the
succulent kit.
Succulent garden kit, the vertical garden kit.
Vertical garden, there we go.
So we have one live, and then we have another one of these that we're going to give away on the next Stampin' Scoop for those of you who aren't live. So even if you're not live or even if you didn't win this live, you still have a
chance. You all want this now because that's what you saw.
I know
you do.
I'm like, I need to go order some more. So the winner of this one is...
Dum-dum-dum-dum.
And... Going, Jen Ward. Yay. Congratulations, Jen. Very exciting. Yeah. So congratulations to all the winners. Be sure to fill out the prize claim form. There's a link in the post, in the Facebook post, if you're on Facebook. And
dropping things.
Our next episode is going to be February 28th. We will be giving away live another vertical garden. For any comments left on Linda's Facebook or Linda's YouTube, my Facebook and my YouTube.
Yep.
So if you've left a comment on any of those channels, it will be entered into the drawing you will be entered into the drawing to win the second.
And you're going to want to come back anyways because you want to see what the heck we've come up with.
We'll have
more giveaways. So,
we will
plan
see
on
you
here.
On February 28th with episode 30. Thanks for joining us, you guys.
Thank you. Bye.